Welcome to Dr. P.C. Verma Economist YouTube classes. In this class, we will discuss how to derive demand curve from revealed preference theory of consumer's behavior. We all know that consumer's behavior through indifference curve, which was established by J.R. Hicks, was rejected by Paul Samuelson on the basis of certain objections raised by him that indifference curve is continuous. In real life, an indifference curve cannot be continuous because of the indivisibility factor related to the commodities. Commodities are not perfectly divisible, and therefore there may be case of bundle of X and Y and discontinuous curve shown by dotted line. And this was the first criticism of indifference curve labeled by J.R. Hicks, René Roy and some other economists sitting there in the discussion. Another objection raised by Paul Samuelson against indifference curve analysis that it is not based upon logic of order, nor it can satisfy consistency postulates. Therefore, indifference curve is rejected by Paul Samuelson, and he established his revealed preference theory of consumer's behavior. And in this revealed preference analysis, we saw that Paul Samuelson established discontinuous revealed preference curve, and X is a function of price. Two commodities, X and Y, are taken into consideration. Price of Y remains constant, only price of X varies, and therefore when we derive demand curve from revealed preference curve, that will be also between demand for X and price of X, and their relationship, own relationship, inverse relationship. Higher the price, lower the demand. Lower the price, higher the demand. Other things remaining the same. This is called law of demand. This law of demand is analyzed with the help of revealed preference analysis. Look on the board. Derivation of demand curve from revealed preference theory of consumers' behavior. In revealed preference theory, first thing is choice reveals preference. Choice reveals preference. Second thing is a strong ordering. Third is consistency postulates. And logic of order. This is in difference called Hicksian. Hicksian view. In difference called Y and X goods. Y goods and X goods. Good X and good Y. And this is revealed preference curve. This is revealed preference curve. Revealed preference curve. Revealed preference curve is dotted line. Revealed preference curve is dotted line. Dotted line means discontinuous. Revealed preference curve is discontinuous curve. Under revealed preference, consumer's behavior is described in terms of choice reveals preference. Paul Samuelson said that there are so many bundles available to the consumer with his income, he will have to find out his own preferred bundle. Whatever his choice, that will be his preference, and that bundle will be his selection. And therefore, he said that in revealed preference curve, what we see that this is price line. This is price line PP1. Budget line. This is income constraints. Consumer had different choice. He can make choice A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K. All these are known as bundle of X good and Y good. Bundle of X good and Y good. Bundle of X goods and Y good. And he has to make a choice whether he will take K, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, A, B, C. Paul Samuelson said that consumer has a strong ordering and he will prefer only one bundle, and he will not be indifferent to any other bundle. He will select one bundle, and if he said that he selects A, if he selects A, then this will be known as preferred batches. A, M, N. In revealed preference analysis, consumers prefers A. It means he prefers A. And he will not select any other, neither he is indifferent to any other combination shown by B, C, K, D, E, F, G. All dotted points are combinations. So what does it mean? That consumer has this price line PP1 and all these are rejected. All these combinations are rejected. All these combinations are rejected. Rejected combinations. Rejected combinations. X goods and Y goods. X goods and Y goods. Rejected combination. This is called a strong ordering. A strong ordering means consumer prefers A. Consumers prefers A. And A is his choice. And any other between this line, he termed it as preferred batching. Preferred batching. Consumer can move from A to M, A to M, if there is variation in price, if there is variation in his income. So he will move from A to M or A to N. But he cannot make any choice between rejected combinations. A strong ordering means once rejected, rejected forever. In no circumstance, consumer will choose out of rejected combination. And therefore, this is called a strong ordering. A strong ordering. It is Paul Samuelson view. And what was Hicks view? Hicks view, weak ordering. Weak ordering. Weak ordering in indifference curve, which was rejected by Hicks himself. Weak ordering was one of the bases on which it was criticized. Continuous indifference curve condition was criticized, and therefore curve must be discontinuous, which revealed preference curve is shown here by Paul Samuelson, that it will, all dots will represent bundle of X and Y. X increases, Y decreases. Y increases, X decreases. And in order to maintain this preference, consumer, a strong ordering is the most important factor in revealed preference analysis. Consumer reveals his preference. In this our case, consumer has revealed preference for A. So long as his income is PP dash, he will stick to A. In no circumstances, he will tip into rejected combinations. He cannot take rejected combination in any other circumstances. Price may vary, price may fall, situation may alter. But one thing is certain, that he will not select any commodity bundle which was rejected by him earlier. This is called logic of order. Logically, if you reject it, Logically, you rejected and preferred A, and A reveals preference choice of the consumer, reveals preference. Under no circumstances, whether price falls, whether price rises, in no circumstances you can select any combination out of rejected combination. Then look here. This is price line. Now price of X falls. Price of X falls. Then the price PP1 shifted to PP0. It means price of X falls, but price of Y is constant, and therefore curve swing from P, swing right side, once swing, it means price of Y is constant. If price of Y will also change, price of X, then shifting will come, this curve will shift upward. So curve price line swing from left to right, and that means X commodity has become cheaper. Now look here, if we draw a line PP bar which is parallel to this line, and suppose this is A, this A bundle was preferred by him, preferred by consumer preferred A. So he preferred A. Now price has changed. Then the logic of order says that whether his income is reduced by some amount, so that he will put to the original point A, he will not remain at A. He is rational. He thinks that price of X has fallen, and therefore he will substitute some portion of Y, some portion of X for some portion of Y. He will leave some portion of Y, and that money he will spend on
X
commodity. So look here, this is, we have to prove, lower the price, we have to prove lower the price of X good, higher the demand for X goods. Look here, this price line, and this is called compensating variation. This is called compensating variation in income. His income is reduced by this amount, PP bar, by PP bar, and he is allowed to remain at A. He is allowed to remain at A. Where he was? He was at A. Price change is not because of him. Price change means, in macroeconomics, price change means inflation. In microeconomics, price change means, in the market, one commodity price falls and one price rises. So if there is inflation, price will rise. If price falls, it means commodity price has become lower. It means some money, real income, has increased. So in order to put him to the original real income, he should be back to point A. And how can it be possible? Then it is said that reduce some portion of his money income to compensate the rise in real income. And therefore he will be put on A, where he is neither better off nor worse off than before. He will be at A, he is neither better off nor worse off than before. Because he was at A. because of the endogenous factor, exogenous factors, price may vary. And consumer is not responsible for that, nor he has brought fall in the price of X, nor he has brought rise in the price of X. When price rises, price equivalent variation means increase his income by some amount. In our economics, it is known as Mahangai Bhatta, Dearness Allowance, DA. So, Dearness Allowance is given. When price has fallen, inflation has gone down, then what will be the effect on the consumer? His, some portion of DA will not be paid, will be withdrawn, because price has fallen. There is no old price. So price has fallen and PP bar amount is taken away from the consumer to put him in the old condition, A. And at A, he is neither better off nor worse off than before. Look here. From A, he cannot choose any of the old item which was rejected. Which was?
Rejected.
What was? These are rejected. These are? Rejected. These are rejected combination. These are rejected combination. So consumer can move anywhere to right hand side. Suppose at J, he can move from A to Z, A to Z, right? He can move from A to Z. Look here, he can move from A to Z, from A to Z. Look here, here he was buying 10 and here he is buying 20x. He was buying 10x, here he is buying 20x. Why? Because price was P and it has reduced to P0. Price was PP1. Price was PP1. And now the price is P bar. Price is PP0. Price is PP0. This is lower price. This is lower price of X goods. Then this will be higher price of X goods. And price of Y constant. Price of Y constant. So what we see, that consumer will move from A to Z, it means he will move from E to E1. He will move from E to E1. And this is demand curve. This is demand curve. This is demand curve. Demand curve. So, demand line is downward sloping, which means lower the price of X. Higher the quantity of X demanded. So by logic of order, Higgs, by logical order, Paul Samuelson proved that he cannot move from A to Z. He cannot move from A to Z, A to P bar. He cannot move from A to P bar, but he can move from A to P bar 1. He can move from A to Z, but he cannot move from A to K, A to L, because these are already
rejected.
So he can move only towards right hand side. He will move from A to Z. Z may be anywhere right hand side, and anywhere means more demand. And this is proved that lower the price, higher the demand, and higher the price, lower the demand. This law of demand is proved by Paul Samuelson with the help of logic of order, with the help of choice given preference, with the help of a strong ordering, and the curve, demand curve, is dotted line which we have derived from this point. So, revealed preference analysis has proved that demand curve and demand law of demand is universally accepted. There was dispute on the basis of cardinal utility. There was dispute on the basis of ordinal utility. He had said that revealed preference is behaviorist ordinalist, and consumer's behavior, it must be consistent. He is at A before price change, and he is A after price change when some money income is taken away from him to put him to the original condition. He is neither better off nor worse off than before, even if the sum income P bar is taken away from the consumer as a compensating variation in income. He remains at A, but he will not remain at A. He will substitute X for Y, and there is substitution effect. Consumer will move from A to right hand side. That right hand side we have taken Z. And Z may be placed anywhere, but between A, after A, right hand side. Consumer cannot move to left hand side, because left hand is in the rejected zone. So a strong ordering of the consumer's behavior is established. Logic of order is established. Consistent behavior is